Welcome to the Windows Club. We are here with a video on a much requested topic, calculating the grade point average or GPA in Excel. The grade point average is an important parameter used to judge the average results of students in most universities across the West, especially USA. Now, different universities have different scales for grade point averages. However, we would use a commonly used scale here, which is 0 to 39% is F grade or 0 value. 40 to 49% is D grade or 1 value. 50 to 59% is C grade or 2 value. 60 to 79% B grade or 3 value. 80% and above A grade or 4 value. The value is important because the formula for GPA is equal to sum of the grade values in all subjects divided by the total number of subjects. The same has been explained in this article on the Windows Club. We would be sharing the link in the description section. While it seems easy, it's a little difficult. Here, we have data with two tables in it. The first table has a list of subjects and percentages scored by a student in these subjects. In another column, we would be calculating the grade just for the sake of it. And in the third column, we would be finding the grade value. The grade value is almost inverse to the grade itself. However, we need a second table to use as a benchmark for calculating the grade value. For example, anything above 0% would count as F and the grade value would be 0 unless the student scores 40%, then the grade value is D and value is 1. For 50% and above, the grade is C, value is 2, and so on. So how would we calculate it? To calculate the grade for digital electronics, which is the first parameter, click on the associated cell. Then go to formulas, select lookup and references, and scroll to Vlookup. Now in Vlookup, we would proceed very carefully. The lookup value for the grade in C3 would be the percentage in B3, which would be the percentage for digital electronics. So we are looking up at the value in B3, which is 89%. What would be the table array? The table array would be the table range of the benchmark table, which is the second table here. So the range is A10 to C15. When I say 2, I represent it using a colon. So it works as A10 colon C15. Both these letters would come twixt a dollar symbol. So I'll add a dollar symbol before and after A and before and after C. Then we need to choose the column index number. The selected column is from A10 to C15. In this column, the column number for the grades which we are using for reference is 2, since it is the second column. So let us type 2 and click on OK. We get the grade for digital electronics in C3. If we need it across the range, click outside this cell and back on it. You would notice a small dot at the right bottom corner of the selected cell. Hover your mouse on it till the plus symbol turns black. Click on it without releasing the click. pull the value down to the last cell in the range. And here we get the necessary grades. Similarly, to find the value, click on the first cell in which you need the value only once. If you click twice, it would select the option for writing the text. So we need to click on it only once. Go to the same formulas tab, select lookout and reference, scroll down to Vlookup. The lookup value is B3 once again, because we are still comparing it with the percentage. The table array is A10 colon C15, both the letters between dollar symbols. And then the column index number would be 3, because the values are in the third column, as you can see. Click on OK. And again, use the fill function to pull the values down to the last cell. Let us find the total of the grade values. Simply select the grade values and in the home page, click on the summation button. So the total of the grade point average values is 18. Now the grade point average would be this total 18 divided by the number of subjects, which is 6. But instead of writing it directly, we can use the formula mentioned in this article. Let me copy paste it. Cell with the sum of grade values is D9. And the total number of subjects is 6. Hit enter. The grade point average of the student is 3. It is a little complex, but I guess if you do it step by step, it wouldn't be so difficult. Isn't it easy after the explanation? If you still have any doubts, please let us know in the comment section. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.